welcome to the book table.
Great to be here.
Yeah, good. And you've got all your books here and a lot of other self-help books. Yeah. Now, you're very well known in Utah. You're something of a relationship expert.
Ask my wife that.
We'll check with her later.
Depends
how much money we're slipping to her, right? Tell us a little bit about yourself. Where do you come from? What's your background?
I have a really kind of a weird background. I have two master's degrees, one in conflict resolution, one in human development, and then a doctorate in human and organizational systems. Oh, wow. I spent a lot of years on the road with a company called Franklin Covey Company.
Okay.
Traveled for them, worked on a lot of their books and their content, and on the side, I became a divorce mediator.
Oh.
I started mediating divorces, and I realized these people, they don't know how to communicate very well. So as we're divorcing them, we started teaching them to talk and teaching them to solve their own problems and communicate. And as we were divorcing them, they finally started talking better than they ever had.
Oh, that's too bad. Better late than never, though, right?
Then we figured out, why don't we just, let's fix this. So yeah. I quit doing divorce mediation and just started teaching communication skills. And it's kind of what got me here. And then a radio show and TV and all these other things.
Yes, because we see you on and hear you on KSL all the time. How does that go?
It's pretty fun. It's great. And then I have a radio show on BYU Radio, which is on satellite radio, Sirius XM 143. So 3 hours a day, I do nothing but talk about relationship stuff.
Okay.
Life.
So you really should be an expert then.
Well, or I talk to a lot of experts. So that helps. Yeah.
What's your new book about?
My book. So I wrote a book called Seven Habits. That's Stephen Covey's book. Don't want to steal Stephen's title. No, but it's the seven basic needs of healthy relationships. It's called Starve Stuff. And what I found is a lot of us fight about the silly things of life, money, sex, kids, all the things that aren't the real issue. But underneath that is this starved issue, I call it. And the starved stuff is seven basic needs that need to be met. You got to have safety, trust, appreciation, respect, validation, encouragement, and dedication. You meet those seven needs, a lot of the other needs go away. A lot of the other issues go away.
Okay. Well, I'm sure Stephen appreciates you saying a little bit about his book. But this one sounds really good because normally we might think, and when you talk to people, they're going to come marching into your office and say, I am sick to death of my wife or my husband spending every penny we have. What do we do?
So we start fighting about money, but money is not the real issue. And then that fight goes to his golfing because he spends more money on golfing. And then we fight about what she bought at the store. And that's what I call the smoke because I noticed that as a mediator, they'd never talk about the real issue, but because the real issue is safety and trust and appreciation, but they'd always fight about money or something else. And what I found is, just like in a fire, the number one killer of a marriage is when that smoke gets in there and starts to slowly kill you and wear you out.
Yeah.
So what we got to do is learn to put out the fire. And the fire is those basic needs that need to be met.
So where does this all begin in a marriage? Why do we end up fighting about money? And basically, we feel like we can't trust our spouse.
Yeah, well, a lot of it comes down to the fact that we don't have the skills. We don't have the tools. And that's one of the reasons I want to write books and get out there in the community. Let's teach these skills, because once people recognize how to fix something, they'll usually fix it. That's what I realized is even the divorcing couples were craving skills. Mm-hmm. And once we gave it to them, I started to see many people didn't want to divorce anymore. They didn't need to divorce because they knew how to feed, finally. We haven't taught people how to communicate and feed each other very well.
It's true, because you think about things even that you learn in college.
Yeah.
You might take a psychology class. I'm sure it doesn't even begin to cover the things that you were seeing.
Yeah, but it actually, in a way, it does. And what I found is a lot of really great researchers are great at creating ideas and researching and getting valid information, but they're horrible at disseminating it out to people.
Okay.
So what I want to try to do is use all my platforms of TV and radio and everything else I do as a way to getting the information out so that people finally have the ideas they need to really fix their marriage and save their families.
Okay. And I can't think of anything more important than doing that. Okay, now tell us, how do people get hold of your books? How do they, you say you have classes, do you do online classes?
Tons of online stuff, free webinars. All you got to do is go to matttownsend.com, and then from there you can go find out. I have classes on anxiety, I have classes on marriage and on conflict resolution, communication classes, literally hundreds of hours of stuff you can get, plus books and audios, ebooks, all of these great tools to get it it into your hands, and you can get them all just delivered to your home.
Okay. Do you do talks to groups as well? If somebody wants to,
place. Do you?
Yeah. And so I speak a lot. Do a lot of corporate speaking, but also just a lot of communities. In fact, that's why we're up here today, is to get the message out and try to see if we can't get the people at the root level, grassroots level, get them the skills, get them the tools, and then let them just start to improve their relationships a little at a time.
Yeah. Well, and realistically, what could possibly be better? We all need to work on our marriages now and then, and you're out there giving the tools to people. Now, we wanted to say thank you to the book table, because you've missed his book signing, guys. I'm sorry to tell you, you've missed that tonight, but lots and lots of your products here.
Well, and they are, and you can, and other products. See, what's so great is get into the store like the book table and actually start reading. Take a chance to just sit down and learn. Start learning about where you're struggling, and you'll be amazed what happens. You'll actually see some change.
Right. And we can't say more than that. Thanks ever so much for coming by today. Matt Townsend, his book, what was it called?
Feeding the Starved Marriage.
Seven Basic Stuff. Just fabulous tools for us all in our marriages, because we all need that from time to time. Come by the book table, get Matt's stuff here all the time.
Check us out on the website. Check us out on just go to matttownsend.com or go look for my radio show.
Yeah, that's a good one. And on KSL, of course. Thanks so much, Max.
Thank you.